My undergraduate degree is in physics and astronomy, and I wanted to be an astrophysicist until I needed an extra class to finish my undergraduate degree. So I looked around and there was this brand new class on climate change that they were offering over in the geography department. I thought, well, that looks interesting. Why not take it? So I did, and it changed my life. When I first arrived at Tech, I had no idea what to expect. Within a couple of months of arriving, though, I got my first invitation to talk about climate change to a non-academic group, to a women's group. So I put together my best slides about science, 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 and I went and talked to this women's group. And then pretty soon after that, there was an invitation from someone there to go speak to their book club. And then someone else asked me to go speak to the senior citizen's home, and then somebody else asked me to come speak at their church. Before I knew it, I was telling more and more people, starting right here in Lubbock, Texas, and the country as a whole. I work all over the world, and people often ask me, why Texas? And I tell them, Texas is the best possible place to be a climate scientist. When I first joined Texas Tech, we were already number one in wind, but we weren't even top 10 in solar. Today, Texas is the number one state in both wind and solar, and upwards of half of our electricity on the grid on sunny, windy days is provided by new clean energy. As a climate scientist, I look at the past, but I also look to the future. I ask the question, what is going to be happening in 5, 10, 15, 20 years, depending on the choices that we make today? And then I work with many of our cities, like Houston, Austin, cities across the U.S., like Chicago and Washington, D.C., and I help people prepare for the changes that are already coming. Now I talk to people everywhere about how climate change is affecting the people and places and things that we love. I regularly give virtual talks. More than 80% of the talks I give are virtual, so I just give them from my home office right here to people all around the world. And the lessons I have learned at Texas Tech and in Lubbock are the lessons that have helped me make that head-to-heart connection and help us also connect our heart to our hands. And that most valuable lesson that I've ever learned, I learned right here. People often say to me, well, you know, do we need to save the planet? I say, no, it's not about saving the planet. The planet will be orbiting the sun long after you and I are gone. It's about saving us. We are the ones at risk, and we are the ones who must prepare. And so that's why my research focuses on the information that we need to prepare for these changes and to keep people safe. The climate projections that we've generated here at Texas Tech, we've used them as part of the U.S. National Climate Assessment. We've used them to study the impact of climate change on corn yields in Uzbekistan, on extreme heat impacts in Chicago. All of that we can do with the resources we have right here. I'm at Texas Tech because I choose to be. I'm at the point in my career, which many of us at Tech are, where I could work in a lot of different places. But I'm here because I'm absolutely convinced that if you can make a difference here in Texas on this issue that I study, we can make a difference anywhere. I see our lives changing for the better, even as climate changes. And I truly believe that these changes will take us to a world where we see bluer sky, cleaner air, more abundant food and water, safer, more walkable cities, a better future for all of us. I'm Dr. Katharine Hayhoe, and I know that from here it's possible.